guys, it's Katie from Team Lucky Little Learners back again with some more teaching tips. This week, we are focusing on Earth Day. So in the following sections, you can use all of these activities to make an entire day Earth Day classroom transformation, or you can use an activity a day leading up to Earth Day. For literacy, we would love to start with a read aloud. There are so many great Earth Day read aloud options. The ones flashing up here next to me are just some great suggestions we've had from Team Lucky Little Learners. You can read more about how to use these read aloud suggestions in the blog post, which is linked in the description below. After a whole group read aloud, there are some center ideas you can do or just some independent work. You can have them write about Earth Day with this great writing prompt. Have them read to self some Earth-themed books. And don't forget to give them this cute little bookmark to stick into the book when they're done or to color and take home. You can assign reading passages or use them with your small group. One thing about Earth Day is we're trying to lower our paper usage. So you can use these reading passages digitally. You can project one on your smart board and do it whole group. Or if you are one-to-one devices or even enough devices for one reading group, you could use them that way. You can use these Earth-themed spelling sheets. I love sound mapping and really pulling these words apart. So these are not only Earth-themed, they are science of reading aligned. Let's hop into math. For math on Earth Day or during an Earth Day classroom transformation, I'm gonna assign spring-themed centers. I kinda wanna review a lot of the skills we've been working on thus far in the school year. And here are the centers I would probably use. Besides those centers, I'll probably use some color by number that are Earth themed, as well as a couple of our Lucky to Learn math lessons. We have some activities and actual lessons that are kind of based around recycling. So here's an example of a Lucky to Learn math lesson that might work, and maybe this Keep the Earth Clean math activity. Now, before I go on, I have to stop and let you know about this amazing deal. For just $1, you can explore all of our Earth Day resources for 1 week in our teacher membership called All Access. All Access has over 20,000 resources that are available to click, print, and teach in a moment's notice. So anytime you're looking for a last minute teaching idea, we have it here on All Access for you. To grab your $1 link, just head to the description. Moving on to science or our STEM category, I am going to do an Earth Day lap book. To save paper, we are going to do it digitally. If this is an option for you, I highly recommend it. It has all of the features of a normal lap book, but everything can be assigned and used digitally. If you are a Google Classroom school, students can share this with you and you can review it, or just simply walk around the classroom and look at students' devices to see if they've done it correctly. We might also focus on recycling a little bit more with one of our newest Lucky to Learn science units all about recycling. It has digital teaching slides. We also have a PowerPoint version if you're more comfortable with that. I'm going to use this teacher's guide to guide my teaching. The students will fill out this one pager and we will also do this reading passage. I'm probably not doing all of this in one day, but the week leading up to Earth Day. Another science activity is to plant seedlings. If you hang these in your window on Earth Day, they should be sprouting within a week or so. Take a look at these. They sprouted in about a week. And the funny thing about this sample is I forgot to hang it back up in the window and they just sat on the counter and sprouted themselves. Now, of course, we have to have some snacks on this special day. One of my favorite Earth Day themed snacks that you've probably seen before is what I call an Earth cup. And so you're gonna take some chocolate pudding, crushed up Oreos and gummy worms, and let students dig in and eat a piece of the earth. Try an art project to enhance the day. We have some really cute Earth Day emojis that look beautiful hanging up in the hallway. Or you can even do this project I've done with my second graders every single year of my teaching career. Start by taking a coffee filter and placing it on top of a white piece of paper. This paper should be thick cardstock so that the water and paint doesn't leak through. You're going to wet down the coffee filter by painting it with blue and green. And I tell my students this coffee filter represents the earth. So paint it, you know, according to how they want it to look, with green being the land masses and blue being the water. We then let this dry for a few hours or even overnight. And when you peel the coffee filter off the next day, you're going to see that you have this really cool earth print. Now students can choose to use either the coffee filter or the print. We cut this out. I like to put either a picture of a Band-Aid or an actual Band-Aid right on there, and my students are going to write about how they would heal the earth. Here are some extra Earth Day ideas for your classroom. Go ahead and try a community cleanup. Just make sure you have gloves and garbage bags. You can also take your students on a nature walk just to explore and enjoy the earth around them. This can double as a garbage pickup as well. Another thing that my school did for many years was we had a person from our county come and talk about recycling and the recycling process in our community and county. She also talked about the landfill in our area. This was very motivating for students to go home and have those recycling conversations with their families. I hope one, two, or all of these ideas help you celebrate Earth Day with your little learners. Do you have other ways you celebrate Earth Day in your classroom? Please tell us in the comments below. Be sure to check out these two videos and subscribe to never miss any teaching tips and tricks.